Cirrhosis is an advanced condition of liver disease that involves permanent scarring of the liver. It is the 11th leading cause of death in the U.S. In this video, we will discuss the causes and complications of cirrhosis. In another video, we talked about the progression of fatty liver disease and hepatitis to fibrosis and then cirrhosis. Once fibrosis begins and scar tissue develops, it can replace liver cells and the ability to function normally. Healthy liver cells have an amazing ability to regenerate, but when the liver cells are replaced with scarring, it is the point of no return. Cirrhosis is a terminal condition with no cure other than a transplant. As the liver cells lose function, production of vital proteins like albumin and blood clotting proteins is impaired. As the disease progresses, the liver will not be able to handle the amount of blood flow via the portal vein. All of the blood from the intestines collects in the portal vein and flows directly to the liver. This is a large vessel, so it can handle the amount of blood coming from the GI system. The nice thing about the tissue in the liver is that it allows the vessels to expand and contract with fluctuations from blood flow. This flexibility reminds me of a water balloon. When the balloon reaches capacity, it continues to expand. While it will eventually rupture, it does have some flexibility, much like the tissue and vessels of a healthy liver. But if you fill a hard plastic bottle, when it reaches capacity, the water overflows. This hard plastic bottle is much like scarred cirrhotic tissue. Note in the picture, you can see the white scarred tissue surrounding the blood vessels. This scarred tissue is like hard plastic with no give. It constricts the vessels so they cannot expand. So when all the blood from the very large portal vein goes into the hardened, scarred liver, the vessels cannot expand to accept the large volume. The blood has nowhere to go, so it backs up into the portal vein, increasing the blood pressure to the point of portal hypertension. Unfortunately, the vein cannot handle the extra volume, so it will back up into the smaller vessels in the GI system. Additionally, fluid seeps into the abdominal cavity and other areas of the body, resulting in ascites and edema. In the end stages, fluid buildup can be quite severe, incredibly uncomfortable, and very dangerous. As the blood flow backs up into the smaller vessels of the GI system, they swell from the large volume of blood. This is especially true in the esophagus. We refer to this condition as esophageal varices. These vessels can only handle so much blood before they rupture. If you recall from earlier, the liver is responsible for making the proteins that clot blood. The swollen vessels, highly susceptible to rupture and loss of blood clotting proteins, is a deadly combination. The final complication is increased blood ammonia. Ammonia is a byproduct of protein metabolism. The liver converts ammonia to urea so it can be excreted by the body. As liver function declines and the ability to remove ammonia diminishes, ammonia builds up in the blood. When levels reach high amounts in the brain, hepatic encephalopathy occurs. Hepatic encephalopathy causes mental symptoms such as confusion, forgetfulness, agitation, and severe personality changes. A person with encephalopathy can slip into a coma, and 80% will die when this happens. As you ponder the causes and consequences of cirrhosis, you should be thinking forward to identify how nutrition is impacted. Use your course resources to consider what nutrients are important and how we will address them in the diet.